Good morning, everyone. We do have some chair over here. Please come inside. My Dharma talk is always very interesting. So, please come inside. Thank you very much. I'm a very hard-working minister. Last night, no, this morning, I went to bed about 2 o'clock. I made a program at the last minute. And then I clean up the shiny the Buddhist torch. And this morning, 4:30, I wake up and then I made sushi for you. So today, I have 2 gifts. One is my Dharma talk, and the other one is my sushi. So sushi is my donation for you. I don't ask our Buddhist Council to pay me sushi. So, my donation, so thank you very much, my appreciation. You may know, but I used to work at sushi bar across the street.
Oh.
And my boss was from Myanmar, and she was a very Christian. And she always used to tell me that, oh, Ko-san. Oh. She always tell me, Ko-san. My name is Ko-sen, but Ko-san. She always say, oh, Ko-san, you know, how grateful Jesus is. We are very grateful. We can work thanks to Jesus. Mm-hmm. And she knew I was a Buddhist minister. She always tell me, how great, that we are living thanks to Jesus Christ. And I was very, very interested to hear. But one thing I learned very important from her was when I was making sushi, when I was apprentice, she always tell me that, oh, Ko-san, you put too much tuna. You know, if you put too much tuna, we may lose money. Ko-san. And then I put too less tuna. Oh, Ko-san, that's too less. Oh, you know, if you put too less tuna, customers complain. So, also, she was a very Christian. She always tell me that middle way is the best way. Not too much, not too less. That's the best sushi. So she always tell me, not too much, not too less. And how great Jesus Christ was. And I knew that, the middle way is not too much, not too less. Not too hot, not too cold. So Hawaii is the best weather because not too cold, not too hot. In Japan, in summertime, it's too hot. It's too humid. And in winter, it's too cold. And a major disaster. So I always feel that Hawaii is like really paradise. Little disaster, sometimes hurricane might come, but as compared to Japan, we are very fortunate. And that's why people don't come to temple. People enjoy this life. And not interested in going to Pyoran. Pyoran is going to be very important, but because this is like really like paradise, we are not so interested in going to Pyoran. So I think I want to know that we are so grateful. We are living in Hawaii. I knew that. And then, thanks to Buddha, not thanks to Jesus. Today, we see some flags. Buddhist, I told you. What is a flag? Do you know this flag? The colors, blue, yellow, red, white, orange. What is a flag? What is that flag? This is international Buddhist flag. So although we are all different denominations, we do different practice, but we are gathered here under this flag. So this flag was designated as international flag in 1954 in Sri Lanka. And so this flag represents what is Buddhism. So we are gathered here under this flag. So what the color indicate? What is the meaning of blue, yellow, orange, white, and orange, I mean orange, and the varieties of color? So first, the blue color represents Buddha's hair. You see Buddha's hair is blue. So according to one of the Buddhist features, there are Buddha has 32 features, and the hair is black, hair is blue, is one of the Buddha's specifications, 32. And so the blue represents Buddha's hair, and it means Buddha's spirit, Buddha's guts, to save our people. And yellow, actually, that is the next color is gold. Gold represents Buddha's body. That indicates that Buddha's teaching is golden teaching. It always shining. It always shining forever. The golden teaching represents. And the color red represents Buddha's blood. Buddha's blood, so compassionate, so hot to save us. You know, to be compassionate to everybody. So that Buddha's blood represents. And white color represents Buddha's teeth. Buddha's teeth, according to 32 features of Buddha, Buddha's teeth is white. So to ease, the color white to ease anger and ignorance, to purity, purify our anger and our ignorance. So the white. And the next color is yellow. Yellow represents Buddha's robe. We call it kashaya. Kashaya. And in Japanese, we call it kesa. Kashaya in Sanskrit word, that means Buddha's robe. So Buddha's robe, yellow, represents perseverance. Perseverance. My parents is not good. Patience. Patience, perseverance, perseverance. So, why Buddhist robe is yellow? Do you know? In Eastern, you know, Asian country, Buddha originally, Buddhist robe is yellow. And I mean today, brown, but mostly brown color. Because the yellow came from the offering of Daiwa. The young couple who had nothing to offer Daiwa. Oh, when they listened to the teaching of Buddha, they were so moved to hear the teaching of Buddha. So they wanted to offer something to Buddha, but they had only Daiwa, very dirty, dirty, you know, Daiwa. So they offered Daiwa, and then Buddha accepted that from the humbleness. So that humbleness is, you know, we are living thanks to Buddha. We are not living by ourselves. We are living thanks to by the other power of Buddha. So that is the humbleness. So whatever we receive is grateful. That indicates Buddha's color. So, you know, that's why yellow indicates, you know, kind of dirty, dirty diaper. But even dirty diaper, Buddha accepted that. So that indicates a very humbleness of Buddha. And the next color, the last color, is a combination of these five colors. That represent the Buddha's light. We call aura in Japanese. I don't know in English we say aura. Aura. The spelling is A-U-R-A. We say aura, aura. Aura. Aura is a light, the symbol of light of Buddha. So that those six colors represent what is Buddhism. Now, I have a very interesting quiz for you. I have two pictures. This picture, cucumber. One picture indicates one cucumber in a small pot. The other picture says that three cucumbers
in a small container, small pot. What do you think grows better? One cucumber in a small pot, three cucumbers in a small pot. So that I want to ask Keith. Here, Mr. Keith.
Yes.
What do you think? The
three.
Oh, you know the answer. According to the common sense, one pot, one cucumber in a pot grow better because the soil, the energy soil is so limited in a place. So if three plants in a small container have to divide, energy has to be divided, right? But one container, he can take everything, all nutrition, energy, one pot. However, according to the technique of the plant, three cucumbers grow better. Because of competition, because of rival, they try to grow. Oh, I think this, that, and this. And as a result, they grow bigger. This is very interesting. However, this container is very small. So cucumber needs to replant the bigger one. Next stage, a little bigger one, and half take one. So that the two can, grow again, rival. And then next time, the bigger container. And next time, on the ground. So that root system, growing, and more, produce more fruits of cucumber. So this is amazing. In the very beginning part of the life, competition is actually so important. The children study, needs to study hard, needs to play sports hard, practice hard. That children are supposed to. However, nowadays education says, oh, education is not a race. Everybody take a step with a journey. This is a journey, not race. That is nowadays education. But I think old folks know this is very true. This is how Japanese American grew up. In a small house, many children, many brothers and sisters, they grow, struggle. That's why they are very strong. I mean the plantation worker, they are very, in the beginning part, hard life, have to work and share the food, the small food has shared. But as a result, their root is so strong, both mind and body, because of the competition, because of the race. So I want you to know that in the very beginning part of the life, competition is very, very important. And do you know Princess Masako in Japan? She is a wife of Prince Naruhito. Her grandparents came from my hometown. And then her grandpa was a principal of the Takada High School, where I graduated. And then the grandpa, Mr. Owada, his name is Takeshi Owada, used to say that first to the student, you should study. Second, you should study. Third and fourth, nothing. But fifth, you should study. The job of a student is study. So he always, according to my father, he was a student at that time. And Mr. Owada used to tell them to students, you should study, study, nothing but study, study, study. So as a result, Princess Masako father graduated Tokyo University and then entered Foreign Affairs, the second top of the Foreign Affairs of Japan. And then Princess Masako was born. She was a smart. I think she received that kind of study hall tradition. And then she graduated Harvard University, one of the best students. She is so smart. And then I used to hear that study. And then I studied. But now I'm Nakatani. Anyway, but this teaching is not ending. Because studying is not everything, you know. The grow as we grow. This is a picture. Look at the root. The tree root. So grown so well. Look at huge. If you have grown, you have, you know, good root system. Competition is nothing. You can co-live together because of so much root, so many roots. You can live by a very tiny nutrition. You don't need to take. But because of the root system, the huge root system, you can live by itself. So this is after, you know, the second stage, or maybe as we grow up, this is something we should consider. If we have a good system, you know, you don't need to depend, but you can live. So I think in the beginning part, competition is very important. Like, you know, nowadays, everybody, I have a smartphone. You know, the smartphone was born, you know, between the competition of Apple by, you know, Samsung, Nissan, Honda, Toyota. Then all competition. As a result, the good product is born according to the competition. But, yes, life is not a race. There is a moment that we knew that life is not a race. It's a journey. It's a journey. There is a moment as we grow up. So until then, you know, children, please listen carefully. Here, listen carefully. Until then, until you grow up, you should study. Okay? You should study. Or if you don't like to study, that's okay. You can pray, you can concentrate energy to something so that you can grow better. But that's not everything. Once you've grown up, competition is nothing. Because you have a root, you have a huge root system, you can live by yourself. Right? So that's what today I wanted to share. Because nowadays, you know, education is not a race. So it may be true, it's true after we grow up. But in the very beginning part, the competition, the race is so important in order to grow up better. Thank you so much for listening to me. Thank you very much.